Hi guys, this is Retractor Carol, and today we're starting with an amazing podcast series called As Know Your Entrepreneur, where we will be having our buddy business owners talk about their journeys and give you their advices, hoping that this gives you some insight and adds value to your career. And if it does, please give it a like, share, and also subscribe to our channel. Thank you.
This is Mandeep Kaur Isgotra, and here we have budding entrepreneur with us today, Mr. Mayuresh Jadhav. Hi, Mayuresh.
Hello, Mandeep. How are you?
I am good. How are you?
Very nervous, but hoping I'll manage.
That's going to be all fine. Don't worry. We're just going to go with the flow.
Let's hope that.
Well, Mayuresh he's not just a budding entrepreneur, but he's also been connected to Rotary Club since past 6 years.
Yeah,
more.
That's right.
Yeah, that's really nice. And you've been nominated 4 times for ARA.
Yeah, right. ARA is Academy for Rotaract Achievements. So, yeah, I've been nominated 4 times for that.
What have you done? I want to know. I would too want to be nominated, yeah?
Nothing much, but yeah, I just gave my best and that was it because I just like to fulfill my role very honestly.
Can we know about your little projects that you might have done that you've been chosen for?
Well, the first project comes to my mind is English Winglish. It was at the time when I was newly inducted in a new club, that is Rotaract Club of Thane Downtown.
Okay.
So that project was mainly for people to help to develop skills of spoken English. So it was along with one another organization. And we conducted that in Khopet near a mandir where the need of spoken English in India is very much needed because we all know how to read and write English.
Right.
But spoken English is something in which I am still developing myself.
Okay.
So we taught spoken English to all the office going people whom they'll need spoken English for their job careers and future. So yeah, it was around 6 months project and we touched around 100 lives. Including 30 adults and 70 kids.
That's an amazing project, and that's something that never came to my mind actually. Like,
yeah,
actually, English these days is much needed. Like, everyone should know so that they can communicate well, just like you and I are.
Yeah, exactly. Spoken English is completely different from what English we learn in school.
Okay. So, talking about your projects and everything, let's talk what we are here for today about your startup.
Sure.
Yeah. What is this startup about?
So I help, my startup is geared towards helping creative entrepreneurs build their dream businesses. And I help them along with designing and marketing. So I specialize in scaling new businesses because there's a lot of scope to scale them.
Yeah.
So that's why I like new businesses more.
So can we categorize into digital marketing or it's different?
So at first it was only a graphic designing startup.
Okay.
But then because of the market need or client's request, I stepped into social media marketing first and I already had developed a neat interest in digital marketing. So I used to learn all the niches of digital marketing and I used to take projects regarding that from my clients. So now you can say it's a upcoming digital marketing startup.
Nice. It's been a year?
No. It's been 2 years. I started this in August 2019.
Oh.
So exactly 2 years now.
And you're doing really great in that.
Yeah.
Well,
pretty much.
It's amazing. That's really nice.
Yeah. Thank you.
So can you just tell me, did you had keen interest into it or you just realized that you have skills and we should just move ahead with it? What just happened?
So at first I was freelancing and now I started freelancing is again a different story.
Oh.
But yes, I wouldn't say I had keen interest in graphic designing. I actually had keen interest in marketing and building a business. And people were already coming to me with a lot of business requirements. So I realized there is a gap between a gap which needs to be filled. And since people were coming to me directly, I thought of coming up with this startup. And here I am.
Yes, you are here. And you are here too, on this chair.
Yeah.
Okay. So how do you work when you're working? Like, how do you work with your clients and how do you take forward?
So at first it was only Rotarians, because they are already familiar with my style of working.
Yes.
So it was only Knowns at first, but then because of mouth publicity, I started growing, and lately I've been dealing with only corporate clients now, because it's very easy to deal with them because they know their stuff and they know how to put up requirement. Yeah. I think that's the rank one pain point for a graphic designer. The client won't know what they want.
Yeah. So now if we realize, like, jab hum chote the, to ye advertising wagera bahut alag cheez thi. And now it has its own name, right? Digital marketing or social media marketing or whatsoever. So do you think there's anything different, or ya fir usi mein ye cheez develop hui hai?
So I think I'll start with how I think marketing. So wherever I go, whenever I see anything, the first thing that comes to my mind is, can I advertise something here? Which type of client will be benefited with this advertising?
Hmm.
So this is how I think. So this is a mindset which I developed.
Okay.
Like now we are talking, and here's a glass of water.
Yeah.
So I can put up a label and name any brand. So now I'm advertising, and this is one of my medium now.
That's okay. Marketing strategy, advertising strategy.
Yeah, right. You just think marketing and everything's easy.
It's easy, right? But वो वैसे दिमाग भी चलना चाहिए ना?
Yeah,
but so no. My question was, do you think there's any development in the past advertising? जैसे पहले होता था advertising, जैसे TV में देख लो, but अभी ये बहुत नई चीज़ है digital marketing.
Right.
So do you think there's any difference, or we are just going with the same thing ahead?
No. It's completely different. So the traditional marketing which we know, you used to see hoardings and banners and everything.
Yeah.
But now in digital world, everything is on your phone or digital platform. So the major difference is, when you are advertising something on a newspaper or a hoarding, you won't be able to measure how much people are seeing that thing. But on the brighter side, in the digital marketing, you are able to track what type of audience are viewing your content and how they are interacting with you, from where they are coming, and there's a lot more.
You wanna say it's all internet?
Yeah, I would say digital marketing is obviously all internet, but probably it will evolve to something better in upcoming years.
Okay, so what are you much focused on, graphic designing or this marketing and advertising?
So at first it was graphic designing, but then I realized the reason why I was good at graphic designing is because I know how to portray the content. So I knew what content to put, how much words to put, and what catchy phrase will attract you. So at that time I realized that maybe I'm more into content marketing.
Mm-hmm.
So I started content marketing then, but then I got introduced to other fields of marketing, and then I knew where my interest was, and hence I stepped into digital marketing, because for me everything in digital marketing, all the niches are very, very interesting.
Oh yeah. Well, we did forget to introduce to your business name. What's it?
So the name goes by Moodboard Branding.
Okay.
And my tagline is Express Your Brand.
And why Moodboard Branding?
Because I think there's a mood for everything, for every brand. Like if you are
nice.
Opening a food franchise,
yeah.
The mood or the strategy, marketing strategy, would be completely different than a corporate.
True.
So there is something, you have to keep something professional, and here you have to make it a little bit funky to attract the particular type of audience.
Oh, right. And why the tagline, same thing?
So yeah, because every brand needs to be expressed, and if they are not expressed well, they just stay where
Can
they
you,
started.
Yeah, sorry. Can you share us an experience with your client wherein you really enjoyed it, like the project that you enjoyed much?
Well, it was my first project, I would say, because everything was new.
Yeah.
So at that time, I put up a team and everything. Like, I knew what I wanted to do and what I'm good at, but this is not enough. You need to know how to pitch a client,
right.
And market yourself, which is again a different thing. So I think marketing yourself is difficult for me.
Well, it is actually.
Yeah. So this was, I was very nervous at that time, like I am now. And But luckily, I had faith in my teammates. They weren't of my same age. They were experienced. So they covered up for me. But that was a big lesson for me.
Yeah.
Like knowing only the technical skills or how to write content is
right.
not enough for a startup or being an entrepreneur.
Is it difficult to step into this world of digital marketing as there's a lot of competition going on these days especially?
Yeah, it is very difficult. And the thing about digital marketing is that you have to keep yourself updated every now and then. Like, unlike other fields where you learn something and then you apply it, digital marketing is not like that. I'll give you an example. So I was doing a course in one institute of digital marketing. So I learned TikTok marketing very well. And it is a very huge, like now we are TikTok. Maybe we won't recollect what TikTok was then.
Yeah.
But I was learning TikTok marketing when TikTok wasn't banned in India. And like once we finished the module, this next day, the news came up that TikTok is banned.
My God.
So yeah, you have to keep yourself updated. And it's a difficult, like it's a skill or an art, you would say. So yeah, you have to keep yourself updating.
Yeah, I see that. But it's quite difficult to keep yourself updated to the new versions or new things coming up, right? At time, has there been a time when you'll be like, "Yar, ye mujhe pata hi nahi hai kya aur ye kab nikla kab hai ye?"
So this happens the every time, but that shouldn't stop you. That is where you should start.
Yeah.
So if you don't know something, you should get into depth of it, and I think that will only happen if you have interest in it.
So, is there any recent project that you would like to share with us which would interest us too?
So, currently I am more focused on my Rotaract post. It is a new post. So, it goes by the name Deputy Digital Communication Chair.
Couldn't hear you, sorry.
Deputy Digital Communication Chair. So, I want to make a community there. So, this is what I'm working on. So, I'm learning community marketing now. So, since I have a platform ready, so I want to make at least 10 to 15 communities, different communities, because it is something which will come up very soon, evolve very soon, and it won't get old any fast, because making a community is your way to talk to your audience personally.
Right.
And not as a brand.
Right. I guess you're going to achieve all the heights you want, because I guess I've seen you somewhere, and it's really nice seeing you reach here and sitting here and having an interview or podcast doing together.
Thank you.
Well, do you have something to say? Like, is there anything that you would want to share during this podcast about your business? Because this is all about knowing your entrepreneur, right?
Yeah, right. So, I would just like to say, like, if you are starting up anything, just don't start because there's a lot of money in it.
Yeah.
Because maybe you'll earn money in the start, but at some point you're going to feel emptiness, that why am I doing this?
Right.
So that would be my advice, to only work on something which you believe in.
Which interests you, right?
Yeah.
Well, do you get bored? Kabhi aisa hua hai ki haan bore ho gaya, ab man nahi kar raha kaam kar, chalo vacation pe chalte hain.
Not yet, I would say, because I've just started.
Yeah.
But maybe in future, if I start working for continuously 9 hours, 6 days a week. So I don't know if I might change my mind. But as of now, I don't think I'll get bored in the world of digital marketing.
You enjoy it? You enjoy your work?
Yeah, I enjoy your work. I like thinking. So that's why digital marketing amazes me.
Do you get up early in the morning and think, yaar, aaj kaam karna, aaj nahi hoga, ye nahi ho payega mujhse? Aisa kabhi hua hai ki you be like, nahi yaar, chalo kaam pe chalte hain?
So kaam pe chalte hain, like yes, a client's work is there. Sometimes you feel like procrastinating. But one thing I follow, like to avoid procrastinating, is just to think for the next 5 minutes. Like if you want to make content for something or a copy for something, so you just think for the next 5 minutes, that in the next 5 minutes, you just have to switch on your laptop. That's it. Right? If you think, I have to make a copy, I have to think content for it.
Just keep bragging
about it. Yeah, yeah, yeah. So that is going to keep you there itself. So just think about the next 5 minutes. So this is what I follow. And I won't say I'm master at it, but yes, I'm learning.
Oh, well. How how about talking about your personal life? Well, this was about the business, and I'm sure everybody would want to know what's personal life. What's your personal life?
So I think I have a very great personal life. So for that, I would firstly thank my parents.
Oh.
Nice. And luckily, I know how to choose my friends. So that's why, I have a great personal life, and I'm very happy with it. It is like a different life for me. The professional and personal life.
Yeah, sure, obviously.
So when I want to do something, a stress-busted activity, I go to my friends and I hang out with them.
Oh, does that, like, during your free time, you go to your friends, or there's something else that you do?
So I would say I somehow know how to manage time. Like, it wasn't something I struggled at. So it's not like I keep a schedule that only this time I'll meet my friend. Whenever something comes up, I schedule my current work, unless it's not that urgent, for the night. And usually, I would say I'm a night person, like working at night.
So you are quite flexible with your working hours and your personal time too.
I'm very flexible. And since I'm a student, I'm currently pursuing engineering. Oh. I haven't even finished that. So I have to keep myself flexible because... college won't even understand that students have a life other than their degree.
I didn't know you were studying. I thought you were just working, like you have completed your studies.
No. I'm in my current final year of engineering now.
Okay.
In DY Patil.
And are you able to cope with your work like and studies?
Yeah, very well.
Hectic nahi ho raha.
I don't want to give a wrong advice to the viewers, but... I put this as my priority.
Okay.
So I missed a lot of my lectures. I hope none of my teacher is watching. Luckily, it never gave me hard and fast consequences. So this was always my priority. And education was like a backup for me.
So engineering, while like your parents wanted you to do, or you were just doing it for the sake of education?
So... That's a painful story. Like, I wanted to shift to commerce after 12th science. But my mom was like, it is something degrading. It's a typical Indian society behavior.
Yeah.
And secondly, I knew if I would take up engineering, I would make my dad proud.
Okay, yeah.
So that was the reason I took up engineering. And I thought, keep 4 years, I'll just struggle. I know, like, I'll keep a stone on my heart and I'll study. But unfortunately, that didn't happen. I'm having a hard time completing my degree because I have no interest in it. Secondly, when you know there's you have an interest in one topic, it's difficult to do something.
Yeah, right. Yeah, I can understand that. But well, you're keeping up with both the things. Like even you are also taking care of your father's wish and yours too. So you're doing both side by side.
Yeah, thank you.
With a heavy heart.
I hope my dad realizes that.
Oh, I just hope he doesn't hear it. Well, don't worry, that's fine. So, any advice for the freshers or young who are willing to enter into any field, I would say?
Any field, okay. So, for that, one major main advice which I would like to give is learn how to invest your energy.
Right.
Because we all know how to invest our money or how to save our money. But when I talk about energy, you and me are talking, so it is taking up some of my energy.
Right.
Now, probably the viewers are thinking that I'm underconfident or something like that. So it is taking up that energy. And investing it in the right place is like if you are here watching the video, you are here because you want to learn something, right? Not because you want to judge how I am talking or if I'm fumbling or stammering. So in that way, learn how to channelize your energy into what really is important. So I think this will help you a lot. And this won't happen overnight. So you'll have to first start observing where you're going wrong. At the end of the day, you might feel you're very drained. You don't have any energy. So that is because you don't know. We have a small number of energy. It's very finite. So that's why you have to learn how to invest it in the right amount. So I think that's one advice.
And
if you're building a startup or being an entrepreneur, I think you'll need a team. So learning how to make a team is very important because for that, you'll have to first know yourself. Like, I'm not good at pitching and I don't have good, I'm underconfident when I'm in front of client. But on the brighter side, I know my work, like how I can scale the business. I know my ideas are really going to work. I have that confidence. So while choosing a team, you need someone who is going to cover up that for you. So I think that is very important, choosing how your team is. We usually, while making a team, we usually think that he is good at this skill. He's good at designing or some specific skill. But the real question is that skill really needed? So that is how you make a team, to cover up for what your weaknesses are. That is going to make a great team. And if you have someone with the same skills, I think there is going to be ego clash. So, and that is, I guess, the major reason why something fails.
Oh.
Even yourself or a startup. So learning how to make a team, focusing on that thing and channelizing your energy is what I would suggest.
That's quite an advice. Because to reach somewhere, it really takes a lot of efforts, and that Mayuresh has surely done. He's not just done with the team, but he has also grabbed all the information that he needed. So honestly, a round lot of applause for you to be here
and
talk to me. Thank you so much, Mayuresh, to be here.
Thank you. You're making me shy.
No, that's... thank you so much. Thank you so much, you guys, for joining us today. And we're just signing off. This is Mandeep Kaur Rasgotra. And thank you. Take care. Bye-bye.
Thank you.